Alright, here we're going to test playing Choplifter with the IBM version of the analog Gravis joystick using Manila adapter. So the joystick's already centered. Chopper is just on the ground there, easy, going up, rotate. If I let go of the stick, it gently lands. All right, so cool. And now we're on the Apple analog Gravis. Seems to drift a little bit, but I don't think it's, that doesn't really feel that different than the IBM converted version. Whoops. And now we're using the Super Nintendo controller with the ByteBooster's adapter, the digital joystick. I guess it does have a tendency to want to go down more than the analog joystick when I let go of it. It's like when I let go, it goes, it really wants to land. I think the analog joysticks kind of felt more gradual, and it, this one I still have to kind of keep on pushing like in an upward position to try to keep it in the air. Whoops. I think it takes, it's gonna, it feels different. It definitely feels different. Not necessarily bad, it's just something I need to get used to. So now we're playing Joust on the digital joystick. Oops. Feeling that the digital joystick benefits more from a game like this. Like, clearly I'm not very good at this. Whoops. So now we're back on an analog joystick. This is the IBM 15-pin joystick with the ManillaGear adapter. I think I'm a little bit more accustomed to playing with the Gravis, but I don't know if it's because I'm used to actually playing with this joystick per se as opposed to a gamepad, which is what the Super Nintendo is more, the Super Nintendo controller is more like. I bought the Super Nintendo controller just for testing out the ByteBooster's adapter. I'm not sure if my poor gameplay is more due to the fact that I'm not accustomed to a gamepad as opposed to a joystick. but the controls are definitely different. You don't get the fine drift, I guess, as you would on an analog joystick as opposed to a digital one, but for the case of these two games, I don't think it matters too much. It's more what you're used to. And if it's just a matter of being accustomed to one or another, you just need to play more of one or the other. I think that if you already have Super Nintendo controllers at home, or Atari joystick controllers, which is what the ByteBoosters adapters take, this would be a good way to use it on your Apple. If you have access to IBM style 15-pin joysticks, then the ManillaGear adapter is a good way to go too. I will say that the analog joysticks from the IBM version as opposed to the Apple versions feel pretty much identical. So it's probably closer to an experience that you would have playing with actual Apple joystick. And now we're back on the Apple Gravis joystick. It's pretty much identical to the IBM analog joystick as well.